NHT.
T. How did you make fighter fluid? Oh.
Again.
Hello. I'm John Cena. I play Superintendent Jake Carson here in the Reading Depot Region 5. As you can see, I'm surrounded by folks documenting my great journey. A journey that you yourself can be a part of. You see, playing with fire in theaters everywhere. This is the outskirts of the depot known as the garage. And when you think fighting fires, you think big red fire engines. Smoke jumpers fight fires from the sky. They repel out of helicopters and planes. So what do they have parked in their garage, you ask? Well, the answer's simple. We fight fires. A big red fire engine. Check this out. This is some superintendent equipment right here. This is a big red quad cab Dodge Ram limited dually lifted, beautifully appointed interior. I really like, you know, the where when a superintendent's head's at. I do like the paint job, even with a little classy touch with the chrome mirrors, LED light bars, of course, so you can see us driving down the highway when you don't see us at 5, 10, 15,000 feet plummeting into fires. Smoke jumpers have to stay in the fittest of fitness. So we have an allocated area for fitness. Awards for 100 jumps. If you look closely at the awards, they're not legal names of smoke jumpers, yet everyone on the set has their name somewhere in the movie. I think that's a really cool, nice touch. We have weights, kettlebells for strength. We have heavy bag for self-defense against fire, of course. And just a general small area where we can do fitnessy type of things. All the chaos is going on behind us, check it out. So the great thing about our little man-made replicated depot is it's replicated after an actual smoke jumpers depot. Our director and producers were kind enough to go up to Reading for a few weeks to talk to the actual smoke jumpers, and in talking to them, gathered as much information as they could about the depot. So this is like the equipment room, and I'm going to walk you through the equipment room to the parachute check, which is actually a real thing. You have everything you would need, axes, carabiners and hooks, tools, chainsaws, a bunch of steel cable, a bunch of chain, certainly a lot of fire hoses, place where you hang the smoke jumper's outfit, and of course the movie magic is dusted, C-clamps and apple boxes and whatnot is dusted throughout. This space, vaulted ceiling, and why? Because this is an actual replica of a parachute check room. Now a parachute is a smoke jumper's greatest asset because they leap into the fire and rely on the parachute to land to safety. Now a lot of those jumps don't land so safely. If you talk to a smoke jumper, broken bones and dislocated joints is a way of life. As a WWE superstar, I can relate. Don't try this at home. But this is a room where they extend the parachute and they launch it out and they check for breaks in seams. They check for that the stitching is all secure. So a lot of time is spent in this room making sure that when they go out of that plane and they pull that ripcord, they're gonna land semi-safely and be able to fight a fire. These are people of a different mindset. It's someone that I truly, truly admire because they do it for the love of doing it. And it is an honor to be able to have them bestow upon us their logo, their atmosphere, to be able to have some fun. I hope when all the smoke jumpers watch Playing with Fire, they laugh along with us, and I'll be the first to say, I'm no smoke jumper, I couldn't train to be a smoke jumper, I couldn't even try to fake being a smoke jumper. I'm trying to do my best as a superintendent of our Reading Depot Region 5, but once again, it's truly an honor to showcase an elite group of human beings that do something that I really can't even put into words how special it is.